Good evening. I'm Toya Washington.
And I'm Kathy Michaelby. The two officers survived, but were seriously wounded. They were in court for today's sentencing.
Officers Brian Norberg and Graham Kunish tried to stop Julius Burton for questioning last summer in Milwaukee's Walker's Point neighborhood, but Burton pulled out a gun and shot them. And now he's headed to prison for a long time. We do have live team coverage tonight, starting with 12 News Mike Anderson at the Milwaukee County Courthouse.
Well, in this case, Toya, a few weeks ago, the defendant reached a deal with prosecutors and that he would plead guilty in exchange for a 50-year prison sentence. The judge had the option of going with that, giving him more or less. Today, she not only gave him more, you might say she threw the book at him.
For the first time, you're seeing the officers struggle with Julius Burton after a routine stop. They're going to go out of frame and we'll stop the tape there, but a second later, they come back into view and Burton fires his gun several times at point-blank range. At sentencing for Burton today, both officers Brian Norberg and Graham Kunish said they survived, but their lives will never be the same.
The bullets led a path of destruction through my face and shoulder that I still find painful to this day. The first bullet entered my face between my upper lip and nose, causing me to lose 7 teeth and most of the bone where the teeth had once been. The injury to my head has resulted in the permanent loss of my left eye and the loss of a portion of my left frontal lobe. Surgeons have had to cut my scalp from ear to ear and peel my facial skin down to reveal the damage.
Members of the officer's family talked about their trauma. Burton's family apologized. Then it was Burton's turn.
I know it was wrong what I did, but somebody was trying to kill me, so I was scared, and I didn't know what to do, and I bought a gun, and I did what I did, but I didn't mean to do it, though, and I just want to apologize to the officers and their family for what I did.
The apology wasn't enough, and though it came out the defendant does suffer from some mental illnesses, the judge gave him 40 years apiece on each count, so he serves 80 years in prison plus 20 years of supervision. He'll be in prison the rest of his life. Live in Milwaukee, Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.